Hello YouTube, this is HellBuddy. Last video, I introduced PHP Day Default Time Zone Set function. This video continues to show how to create PHP function with that and how it helps on web development. For example, mostly website will show the copyright year at the page bottom footer section. But sometimes when I visit the other websites, I find out the year has already expired like this. In a word, it will have bad impressions sometimes because we know many websites are abandoned and hang on the free host servers in a long time. Also, the owner can show the updated or add modified post stay beside the contents. That may be helpful. However, people want to see the newest information. They will doubt if the site was not alive. The expired years will hurt the site truthful. How to fix this as well? For this tutorial, I show you how to easily use PHP function. Let me create a variable open day and then use day function. Into the parentheses, I put two single quotes with uppercase Y to echo out the current year. Let me save the page and refresh the browser. It showed 2014. And then use string to time function to format the day string. Into parentheses, put two single quotes. Put add year in it. Let's try add 1 year. Save and refresh the page again. Let's echo out 2015. Now change to minus to decrease 1 year. Let's echo out 2013. Let me use the same function to create the other variable currents to show the current year. Now I want to put these two variables into one single line, like from open day year to current year, and try run the code again. Now I'll put negative 1. For this, actually, PHP doesn't understand that, because it's kind of like mathematics. One variable minus the other and will equals to something else. Beware the minus, it wants it to be as dash. Put single or double quotes wrap around to make strange. Run again and echo out, now it's okay. If you put this 4 lines code on every single page footer, if you have 1,100 page footer, it would become nonsense. To make program more efficient, remember, do less code, more functions. We need put it into the function. Let's see how it works. Let me create a function name called footer. Has parentheses after that. Use open and close curly braces wrap around the statement. Try run the function. Now you see it's blank because you need run out the function name. Let's do it again. Now that's what I want. Let's take the function name out and save it in function.php file and then go to the footer page. We need to paste the function code on every single footer page. Let's start the PHP code here and with footer function. We need to access the file which the file holds the statement and run out the function. Now function.php and footerDay.php, they both beside for each other in the same directory. Now I use require once or include once function to connect the file. You may use parentheses. For me, I like simple use two single quotes. Because two files both into the same directory, so just directly put the file path link in. For the path link, if it's inside the other folder, you maybe type folder name and then the file. Or sometimes you will see like .docs/. If you have any question about the path link, you can watch my the other tutorial, but right now, simple type function.php. Let's run the page. Oh, I got error. Let's see. Oh, it's missing a semicolon right there. Okay, so save it, run again. Boom, you see the function makes the footer work. Why use function? For example, I want to adjust the open day years because it's not accurate. The minus years based on the current years, that means 2013 will become 2014 on next years. If you want it, that's fine, but I won't make the actual days as 2010. Let's run the update code again. It works. So I only change it on one single function page instead of many pages. It's flexible, maintain all of the pages updated. Also, it helps the good impression of website development.